In the previous video, I have created the environment with code spaces, with Ansible controller and a bunch of nodes. And I'm going to start deploying this application, which includes front-end catalog cards. A part of this code is already available as part of that repository that I have just checked into that, you know, to the workspace. And I'm going to begin by providing some common configurations using some playbooks and start observing the code which is given here in this repository, which is the Ansible directory, subdirectory of that. And this is where I see a bunch of YAML files and then a few directories, including roles, environments, group wires, etc. I'm going to start making sense of this code, and this will be useful for you if you have been given some Ansible code and if you want to apply it. This approach is going to be useful for you. So this is our architecture. So we have front end, which connects to the catalog and cards. Each of that has its own database. Now, if you translate it into a diagram and the layers, it can actually translate to these many layers, and each of that can be an independent layer with a bunch of instances of the same application, even the database. For example, catalog has catalog DB, cards has cards DB, and each of that, including the database, can be scaled horizontally. And that's what we are going to write the roles for. Now, first thing that we do is create an inventory so that Ansible knows which hosts are available and which hosts it should be managing. And inventory is nothing but a list of hosts along with the class or the group that it belongs to, because not all the hosts are same, not all the hosts are going to behave the same and run the same application. Some of those will run front end, some of those will run catalog, some of those will run cards, and so on and so forth. So you have to have a way to differentiate that, and that's where we create the inventory. Now, the inventory is already available here. There are various ways you can define this inventory and various places. In my case, I create environment specific inventory. So I have an environments directory inside which I have dev as a file, which is an inventory for my dev environment. And this is where I have created. This follows INI style configuration where you have blocks of configuration, let's say front-end, catalog, cards, and then you have list of servers, and then you have a group of groups, which is dev. So all of these, front-end, catalog, and cards, belong to this dev group as well. And in addition to the list of servers, you can also define, let's say, the ways to connect to that server, including the password, username, keys, any of those connection information can be part of Ansible inventory. So this is where my inventory is, and I can, once I define the inventory, I can use Ansible utility to connect to these hosts. So before you actually start using playbooks and all, you should definitely understand what inventory is. And I also have ansible.cfg, which has the configuration which points to my environment's dev. So even if I don't provide the inventory path, it's going to be okay in this example. That's what ansible.cfg is. And I can start pinging and validating that I am able to connect to this host by running Ansible utility. And when you use Ansible, you can either provide the inventory using -i option, but since I have ansible.cfg defined, I don't have to provide that. I can directly run Ansible commands. And when I want to connect, I can define a bunch of servers. That's the host pattern. In this case, I'm saying that all my servers, and I'm using a module called as ping. That's like a smoke test that, you know, I'm able to connect to these, and everything return green, which means that I'm able to connect to these hosts using this inventory file, which has been chosen automatically by ansible.cfg. And I can also provide some patterns. The pattern that I used was all, but I can also provide a group of servers as part of my inventory. These patterns are defined in the inventory. So let's say I use Ansible frontend, it's going to connect only to the frontend servers, or in this case, dev contains frontend, catalog, cards, everything. So it's connecting to all of that. You can also provide some host pattern, interesting combination, using colon. And then here I'm asking it to connect to all in dev except for frontend, or cards and frontend, you know, colon is for exception and excluding, and this is like a combination, cards and front end. So it shows me only two servers which are part of the front end and cards right there. Now you can use these host patterns flexibly to connect to a subset of the servers as part of your inventory. Inventory is defined here as part of that static file. Inventory can also be dynamically defined by, let's say, cloud provider. You can also feed in the environment inventory file using minus I option. We have a default set, so we don't have to do that. So in this video, I showed you how to, you know, how the inventory works. We have used an inventory which is already there, and I also talked about host patterns so that you can select a subset of host to connect, and we just validated that using the ping module.